Well, I think the strongest argument is that at present, that's the only known way that we can make connection between string theory and the present world. I mean, I think a large fraction of the community don't like that idea, but nobody has come up with anything better. And the second argument is that it doesn't seem to contradict any of the known laws of nature, that if you have phases of string theory or vacuum, which with large cosmological constant, and which is sufficiently long-lived, then multiverse seems to be an automatic consequence of that. I think finding a direct evidence is hard because by its very nature, it's impossible to communicate with the other worlds. Okay? What we may be able to find is indirect evidence that in the lab, for example, by if we have a very high energy collision, we may be able to create a small region of some of the other phases. And that would be the indirect evidence for a possible existence of multiverse. But I don't think there is a direct evidence in the sense of actually detecting the other worlds. Well, it can happen in the early phase of the multiverse that the basic idea of multiverse is that you have a big expanding universe which is expanding very rapidly and part of it is making continuous phase transition, but the expansion rate is so big that it wins over possible other phases which are being formed. Now, it can certainly happen that two of these phases form independently but not very far from each other. And then before the expansion of the universe separates them out, they may collide. And what's going to happen in that case is that the phase which is more stable will win over. It's like if you have an expanding sheet of ice, okay, and water, say when they collide, then whichever is the more stable configuration, either the water will be converted to ice or ice will be converted to water. It depends on the temperature of the system.